for Java Jive and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me.
I'm just doing my tournaments. I'll show you how quickly you can do these things. If it turns out that I'm wrong, then I will just have to retreat on what I've said. You should be able to take them out with archers, and they should not be able to kill more than one archer each, so I think we can just use these. I've got plenty of them. And I'm going to auto fight it. Oh, there you go, that didn't work. Right, well, let's have a look what we can do here. I'm not going to auto fight it. I'm going to just have a look and see what happens if we do it this way. See, the problem is auto fight will take the archers forward, and then they're going to perhaps get messed up. So what we'll do is we'll just hang back and let those people come to us, and then we should win it. There she comes. You see, she's got one of ours. Okay, so let's give her a smack. She's got big squad sizes, has she? Okay. We should have weakened them enough there. I think we should still win this fight. Right, let's give her a smack. She weakened me, you see. So I didn't get any. But this one is full strength, so we should take her out now. Pretty damn close. Give this one a smacky pat there, and then we'll just give that one. So we're on a high level at the moment, so their squad size is high. If I had fought this 2 days ago, I would have lost nothing. However. Right, so there's one fight done. And for a level 6 fight, that's probably not too bad, having lost 2.5 stacks. Right, next one. Okay, this lot we should be able to do with Treants. Let's have a go. I haven't pre-rehearsed any of these, so you'll see. Righty, we always spread a wide net. So we'll just keep moving here. It's getting late in the day. And the tournament is very close. Okay, now this next round, she's come out. I ignore the hellhounds, they don't do much damage to Treants, nor do these, they don't do much to damage, nor do those. So my prime concern is to get rid of her. So let's just keep the net moving closer. See, now we are within striking range of her. The trick is, that one will just have to stay where he is, let's put him there. Don't move that one forward, because if you do, she'll go over there. So what you do is move it back. See, you are now asking her to come to you. Let's see if she's stupid enough to do that. Not entirely. Okay, it still looks good. Right. Go there. I'll go there now because I want to chase her this way. You see, I want to chase her this way. I don't want her to go that way. So let's see what happens. I'm not going to worry about that hellhound. I want to get into the fight. This one, we will just go there. We are hitting her and we're also getting close to the cannon. Good. Things are looking lovely. Absolutely looking up. Remember, it's a level 6 fight, so I'm not anticipating coming out of here with no troop losses. I think we'll go there, just neutralize him a little bit. And then I think we'll just go there. And that should be the end of her, so now we can auto fight because these other guys won't kill me. So I can finish the fight quickly. We now have 55 minutes till the tournament ends. Yeah. Good. Next one. You will do something. This is not going to work. You're not going to be able to get enough people out. You're going to take massive losses. These are ranged, all of them are ranged. They'll peg you off from behind the head, surrender it. Here we go, back to province, and what do we do now? We're going to cater it, aren't we? We will have to cater this one. Here we go, cater. Okay, forget. It's theoretically possible that you could do a trick with archers, but he's going to eat archers, so I think you must just cater that one. There we go. Good, that's another province down. And these are level 6 provinces. Everybody's whinging and moaning and saying they can't win with level 6 provinces. This character we're talking about here is but basic fighters, and he's not even in Dwarves yet. He's in the chapter that comes before Dwarves. He's my second city. And I would think that you would agree that he's doing not too badly. Right, let's see what they have in store for us. Okay. Well, this one's obviously got to go there. I'm going to smack at that one. I think that you want to go up that side, so if she goes in that direction, you've got to hit it to her. This one, remember, we're not going to bring forward because he's wounded, he's got no strike power, so we'll put that one there, bang. And then we'll bring this one over there. And, oh lord, wrong one! Oh, damn, okay, well, I moved him back. Right, here we go. So far, so good. Okay, so she knows what I'm trying to do. She's not stupid. Alrighty. So let's have a look what we're doing here. See, they don't do any damage, these things. And these boys only do damage when there's a curse on the player, like that curse there, you see. So I suppose you better bring this man back in again. They've outsmarted me, and we'll have to take as much off her as we can, which is fine, that's too often. And then we get to get into fight with this one who's still healthy. Get rid of this stupid dog, get him out of my way. Here's a thought, we can take that one out because he won't be able to strike back if he's dead. Dead men don't strike back. So there we go. Alright, so she's still being quite coy. But we're going to hedge her in on the next round or so, you see. And then she won't be able to pull the silly tricks. Righty. Ach, you might as well just take that chap out, get rid of him. And you see, I don't really normally go for these dogs. Because they attack you and they wipe themselves out from your strike back. But in this case I want to get through here, so I'm going to have to kill him. Let's give her another tickle. So we've knocked 3 off her so far. But more importantly, we are closing in on her, are we not? Yes, yes we are. Here's the thought, let's just go there and give him a hit. We might just get rid of him that way. And then we'll come over here heading for that direction. Okay, well that was pretty inevitable. Good. I think we have this one, because we're going to get a full strength hit onto her, you see. Right, so check now. Go away, he'll stop annoying me. This one can give her her first full smack. How did you enjoy that? Loved it. Okay, and you may as well just neutralize him a tiny bit. And I think you will agree we have won this fight now, so we're going to want to fight it because we're getting closer and closer to the end of the tournament. I want to finish here, so we're going to fight. And we win that one. And we'll win quite nicely for a round 6 fight. Okay, let's see what else we have to do here. That's easy enough. I'm not going to bother to fight that one because you've seen these things have no power against those things, so we'll just go wag. Here you go. Quite successful. Lost 2 stacks, but I've got enough stacks. I'm sort of more eager to get this tournament over now. Get as many points out of it as I can before it's over. So, same story. well, we should win this one, because it's open terrain, so they can't hide behind things. So, let's just go there. Go there. See, I'm keeping back because I don't know, if I come forward with this wounded guy, then she will retreat. So I've chosen not to do that. Okay, let's do that. So we haven't managed to get a smack at her yet. But I don't know if she's going to be clever enough to go walking away. I think she will probably have a go at this man. Let's have a look. No, she is clever. I think they get more clever on round six as they defeat them steroids. But it doesn't matter. Don't see us losing this fight. Okay. That's all you can do. And the next thing to do is to bring this man there. And the next thing to do is to bring that man there. The next thing to do is to take him out. So now she can't hide any longer. Now it's 3-1, and she really, really, really ought to lose. But who knows? Other things than this have happened. Okay, let's go that way. So we bring him up into the fight. Then let's go that way. And let's go that way. So if she goes this way, we've got it covered. Great. We're going to lose a lot of troops here, but it is a round 6 fight. You do lose troops on a round 6 fight. These hellhounds are no useless. They're just blocking me. That's the only function they have at the moment, is to stop me from being able to fight them. So if she goes that way, I'll go this way. If she goes that way, I'll go that way. So that man's nicely placed. Oh, you horrible round, but I can still get through there. Right. So she won't be able to escape out the left-hand side or the right-hand side, so I think we've got her now. Yeah, she's caught in a corner. I just want to make sure that Autofight doesn't do something stupid here now. So I'm not going to fortified. Now I am. So I go there, take a swipe at her, and now I'm fortified. Because she can't get away from there, is it? What is this fool doing? I don't believe it! Did you see that? I had him right next to the enchantress, and he just walked away and hit something else. That's why I don't fortified, you see? Good. Ready. Okay, let's see what we can do here. Okay. There's no enchantress there, so you can auto-fight this. Good. Okay, now I'm running out of troops at this stage, but I've already got 3... I've already got 3 six-star provinces. I don't know if I'm going to be able to make this one, we'll see. But I'll show you what else I've done over the last 5 days. I've got 4, I've got 3, I've got 4, I've got 4. I might actually go here now with some knowledge points. And then I've got 3, 2, 2, 2. And this is I don't, this account does not have a martial ancient wonder. I don't have any monastery or needles. This is a straight, in fact, let me show it to you. And I'll come back in. I want to show you what we're talking about, because people are going to say, Jack, you're not like us. We are tiny little players. We don't have big cities. We haven't got all the smart things you have. Well, I haven't got smart things. This is my spare account. And it's pretty humble, isn't it? It's not a fancy account. I have got 1-2 big armories, and 1-2 smaller, and a tiny one, the 3 in fact. So all this account has is armories, so I do have enough troops. But it doesn't have a lot of factory production. It's got 3 little dusties, and it's got a couple of plankies, and Yeah, so it's a humble province, and I can't even remember what level I'm on, but I rather suspect that I'm on level chapter 5 here, because I don't come here that often. I just come here for fun, to make videos, to show you people. Let's have a look, just to see where I am on the tech tree. And there you go. It would appear that I'm in chapter 4. So here you are, this is a humble little chapter 4 city. It has a couple of armories, nothing else, and me. I suppose that's it, and me. Alright, so let's have a look now at some more fights. I'd like some KP. I don't particularly want broken shards, because I don't own any wonders in this city, and I didn't intend to build any. So let's see if we can get those KPs quickly. Right, what does he want? Da 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 da, no enchantress, fight, water fight, bang, 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 ready. Okay, let's look at this one. Two enchantresses, cater. Right, let's look at this one. I can afford to cater it, let's do that. Good, so I just need one more and then I can get those 5 KP. Okay, and here's the last province, which is an order fight. So let's do that. 5 triads, water fight. Cool. And there we go. We've done that province. And there you go, I get my 5 knowledge points. So people are telling you you're not getting knowledge points in this tournament. This little chapter 4 city has made a hell of a lot of knowledge points now, and not for massive losses either. Let me show you. In the course of this tournament, I've done 3 sixes, 1 5, another 5, a 4, a 3, another 4, and a 3, 2, 2, 2. Now I want to show you, I am in fact out of marble now, and I did earlier today buy 3 units of marble from the wholesaler. It's going to be too expensive to buy more. More to the point, I have no planks. So I think we've got to accept I've done what I can with this province, but I'm quite happy. And I'm going to sign off now, and I'll show you, I'm not in a very strong fellowship, but I'm going to show you the fellowship bonus we got. You see that the new prep tournaments really do work. Righty, well, I've just come back a few minutes after making that video, and here we are. And this just gives you an idea of a comparatively small, humble fellowship. And look what we've made. We made 9 crystal relics. We made 15 knowledge points, and there we go. We made 6 rewards, which were on the top line 3 rune shards, and on the bottom line 6 different spells. Well, I mean, that's better than being slapped in the face with a wet glove, isn't it? So there you go, and I'm going to just quickly take you to my other fellowship and show you what you really can make there. This is a much bigger fellowship, but look at that. 4 spells, 14 relics, 35 knowledge points, another 3 spells, some more spells, 1 random rune, another random rune, 1 more random rune, 1 more, 1 more, and I actually got 300 global ranking points. So we did. This is a bigger fellowship, this one. Also in beta, but you know, look at that. If you add that to what we made in the fighting, then this new tournament is giving far, far more than the old style. This particular fellowship, the people who play with me here are not great tournament people, and yet we have opened 8 tournament chests. Okay. Well, there you are. So I've showed you what I set out to show you, and if you enjoyed this, then please like, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and then you'll get to see more videos of the same kind. Thank you for being with us, and have a really lovely day. Bye. Yeah.
A cup, a cup, a cup.